I think he shows that architecture can actually touch people, that it can make the quality of our life much better, that we can experience the phenomena of nature through good architecture in another way, that it makes the experience of landscape and the climate a much more poetic experience. So I think his architecture is an architecture that adds to our experience of the everyday.
Yo creo que ha sido un arquitecto difícil de encuadrar en una línea, escribirlo en alguna línea concreta es muy difícil. Es un personaje muy autónomo y también proviene de una cultura un poco periférica.
What any human being would like is to be completely free to use what's in yourself, to use every force you have in yourself, every skill. And Goethe, you know the author Goethe, said in a letter from Venice when he studied Italian architecture, he was interested, he said, give me a job so I can devote myself with love and skill, 100%. Then it is not a job anymore. Then it becomes an art, an expression of love. This was our promise.
The most important was that his father's work as a boat designer gave him some of the skills and abilities to make things and to work with very complex shapes, three-dimensional forms. His uncle was a professor in sculpture at the Royal Academy in Copenhagen, and so as a child he had many contacts to artists and he learned to draw very well at a young age. And so it was natural for him to develop in this direction. He actually wanted to be an artist, to be a painter, but his uncle, the professor in sculpture, persuaded him that maybe he should take a more practical profession, and that was why he became an architect.
Normalmente casi todo lo que trasciende de él son esquemas. Él reduce toda la complejidad de su arquitectura apenas a dos trazos, ¿no? Las nubes, la plataforma, la tierra, la línea del horizonte. Está constantemente dibujándola por abstracción, porque nunca dibuja el horizonte, pero está muy claro que él está dibujando siempre la tierra y el aire, ¿no?
It's very important for him how people feel, how they experience the life, and that his architecture creates a background, almost like a stage for human life. That's his understanding.
We feel ourselves when we make this thing as Australians and as members of a new culture of our time. And you know that there's been hundreds of architects working on the competition. We have worked hard too. So it's up to you in the easy way. You just paid. That's the easy thing. Thank you.
Hudson es una persona que muy joven gana un concurso sorprendentemente para todo el mundo, ¿no? Gana un concurso de la ópera de Sydney. Él gana el concurso aproximadamente a mediados de la década de los 50 y el proyecto tiene una elaboración muy complicada, una ejecución muy complicada y termina inaugurándolo la reina de Inglaterra pues en el año 1973.
Utzon, he was very concerned with building the building, so he didn't involve himself too much in the politics until it was perhaps too late, because he was very focused in making the best building he could possibly do without compromise. And maybe there wasn't such an understanding amongst the politicians who used this for their own purposes. There was a change of government, and the new government made a political campaign about saving money. And one of their ways of saving money was to take more control of the design process and use their own government architects in the project. So it was a great disappointment, of course, that it didn't happen that way that he had to leave the project. But I think in his own head, this building was completed. He'd imagined the opera house entirely. Also, the interior had been designed.
Yo creo que es un icono de la modernidad, un icono vibrante de la modernidad construida a partir de unas referencias muy claras al pasado. Es esta construcción de una plataforma, de esas shells, de esas cáscaras que se disponen sobre ella. Es un edificio vibrante en cuanto a la luz. Todas esas cáscaras están recubiertas de unas losetas cerámicas muy pequeñas, unas brillantes, otras mates, que aluden a las construcciones islámicas de esas grandes mezquitas, con esas cúpulas, con esos mosaicos, con esa loza, con ese color. Creo que es un edificio emblemático, ¿no? Pequeño pabellón que construye a mitad de su carrera en el año 39 hasta su última casa que construye en 1994 en Mallorca, pues ha habido muchos proyectos, ha hecho tanto casas como proyectos de edificios públicos, muchos no los ha podido construir él debido a la importancia que le supuso estar más de 10 años o casi 10 años al frente de una obra tan grande como la ópera de Sydney. Pero yo creo que la estimación a la construcción del universo doméstico, el esfuerzo que ha puesto para construir sus casas, tanto en Dinamarca al inicio, después en Sydney y después en Mallorca, creo que es un motivo también de reconocimiento a la unidad familiar.
Many of his houses are built around courtyards to give a possibility for a private space for the family, but usually connected to a collective organization of houses. So there's the possibility to both have a private family life, but also to be part of a community.
Después está la Asamblea de Kuwait, en el que prácticamente hay una semejanza con la arquitectura islámica, esa adicción, esa construcción aditiva de una ciudad a través de pequeños elementos que luego se cubren, ¿no? Todo eso está en esta obra, ¿no? Sin dejar de ser contemporáneo y absolutamente moderno. Es como alguien que pensara en ese sentido original de que lo vernacular se encuentra quizá en el sueño propio, ¿no?